going on YouTube? Team KYP here with
Captain OJ,
Guard Cam, and
Ninja Boy.
And we're here to talk about the freaking list that the ban list.
About goddamn time.
Man. Yeah. We're actually like me and Captain OJ already like reviewed most of the list, and like I'm happy with a lot of the Drake or stuff that got hit. But also, like, there was another one of my card, like,
I'm disappointed.
Yeah, I was like, what? Why the hell did that get hit? But we'll start from the top and we'll go to the bottom. So first, Dynamite.
I'm glad it's bad.
Yeah,
it's
that card was cute. Cancer. Garbage.
I never fought one.
Oh, it's garbage.
Whenever your opponent activates a card effect, mm-hmm. they bring out one of their traps.
Yeah, and just put it there right away.
Activate it.
So they can activate either the continuous monster or Call of the Haunted. Back or yeah. half your opponent's attack.
Oh, yeah.
Either way,
it was garbage. It was fucking garbage.
And then it gave your opponent the opportunity to tribute summon again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then we're happy.
I never fought.
In all good terms, I think a lot of people are happy this card's dead.
Because nope.
Yeah, but then okay, the next card is the Grand Soil Elemental Lord. That's the Earth one.
I'm not quite sure about why that's
It was an FTK with the dinos.
Yeah, yeah. From what I was hearing, it was an OTK-based
So that was interesting that they actually banned out that card. Because like most of the dino ones I actually went against, I never seen him actually.
No one either, but...
If either he just didn't come in hand or...
No one had them.
It was just hard to find. No one used them.
Surprised that one got hit.
Yeah, I don't know. That's what I was surprised about. And then... True King Lithogasm. I say Lithogasm,
Yeah. Anyway, with that, I personally find that they hit it early.
Yeah.
But the reason why they hit it early was because of the eventual dinosaur.
Yeah.
That's gonna happen.
Right. Oh man, the dinos will rise. They should have let that go, cause just cause like dinos haven't been like.
They were relevant for like a make believe format for worlds, you know. So it's like.
They were around for a little bit.
Yeah, it was stupid though. They should have let it happen because I
should have.
Mm-hmm.
I was just going to whip out my evil swarms and be like, ha!
Well, that brings us to the next one too, like Denlong. Denlong got cut because of the dinos as well. Because like Denlong was like in every dino deck that was out there. Just because like he makes the rank 9 plays where you can go into your. What was his name? The Calamities?
Yeah, Calamities. But for the most part, people were using it to get out the Yangtze trap, and the Yangtze trap allow for a single negate of like anything.
Wow. Okay.
And I think it was even a counter trap, so you can counter trap a counter trap. So it just made it that much more stupid.
Wow. Okay. That makes more sense.
So it makes sense as to why they banned him, but at the same time, it feels like it's a bit preemptive.
Yeah.
You know.
Right. Well, now we gotta hit it anyways.
Yeah.
All right. And our next one is Digusto. I would actually have said that card got hit because like even it like. I mean, yes, the zoos abused the shit out of it, I agree, but I don't know, as a card, I was like upset that, I mean, like Ojo was saying that there are cards that can do what he can do, but I don't know, I just don't find that they banned him, like, that was like, if there are other cards that can do what he can do, it doesn't make sense why he would be banned.
I'm like, it was really worth it banning him,
yeah,
because now Zodiacs are dead. They're gone, you know, there was the point really still there, or valid, you know.
Oh, like that's what I said, that's like even on the next, Zodiac, Broadbill, and Dryad, and they both murdered.
Oh, goddamn time.
Not even limited or anything, just
fully banned.
Killed, like, dead.
Yeah.
Next one is Ignis Heat, the True Draco Warrior.
That one I kind of wish. In all reality, like it wasn't really meta relevant.
Well, people still ran him, though, right?
Yeah, people still ran him. Just it's not really meta relevant.
Mm-hmm.
The reason why people weren't running it because it searched for the spells, and like, the deck is still playable because they still have Masterpiece
at 3 and Diagram at 3.
Yeah, and Diagram at 3, but all the major enablers that allowed them to be able to like start building a board, you know, are gone. So we'll have to see what happens with those guys in the future. But
so who got limited was Miscellaneous Source. He got limited.
I'm somewhat glad about that because now the dinosaurs don't have the generic like protection for the whole
main phase.
You
like,
can't stop them, you know. So it's like, okay, I'm glad that got hit.
Mm-hmm. Rapier was limited now.
Okay, no honesty with Rapier.
You should have just left it since you can't.
Yeah, because now the card itself is pointless to be able to use that effect.
Mm.
What was the next one?
Dark Hold, which was limited, which is like I find that weird that like two, like it's, I mean, yeah, I guess like they must have seen like most of the meta had two, but it's like you need it, you need wipes.
At the time we needed board wipes.
Yeah.
Know?
Well, especially with the, well, you know why they probably did it? Because of the Chalice deck, because it's super weak to board wipes.
Yeah, that's true.
Because like you drive Dark Hold, they're fucked. It's like, well, that happens.
Bullshit. It's wasting time.
And then even if they do have a by chance they have something to stop it, then it's like, okay. Well, some people have Raigeki on hand too. It's like, whoa, fuck. But yeah, I'm surprised they did that to Dark Hole, because like, why?
I don't know. I like the board wipe, but at the same time, I only ever really sided it in most decks. Dark Hole and what's the next one on the list too?
Next one is Gateway.
It's Gateway. Okay, I'll get to that one in a second. Yeah. But the one right after that is Slumber. Yeah. Okay, so with Slumber, I can understand it being, you know, limited because it enables OTKs.
Yeah.
And, you know, you
field wipes and field wipes. Just do that. Alright, just blow up the field. Yeah. Whatever's on there just gets grown.
I mean, even with like my BLS Invoked deck, that was like the most common OTK play I could do is, alright, if I'm going second, Kaiju the board, or Slumber the board, everything's gone, I get the bigger Kaiju. Ritual Summon, get out BLS, I got all the effects. Normal Summon Alistair, get Invocation. Invocation activates, get out Macabre, search for a spell. So now it's
yeah,
like...
Yeah, negate, a spell negate two in hand.
So I attack once with Black Lesser Soldier, do 3,000, attack you again for 3,000, attack you again for another 3,000.
Yeah. And like even you just did.
So even if that rumor was true about the life points going to 12,000, you were just fucked anyways.
Yeah, you already got so much damage.
Yeah, so it's like I said, I understand why Slumber got hit, but Dark Hole, I really kind of wish it maintained that too.
What's that one?
Yeah,
it's that one now.
Oh. I didn't find issues with that. They want to protect their link monsters.
Their future investment.
Yeah. So Gateway of the Six is our next one. Just future buys, because they're bringing like all kind of Six Samurai support in the future.
Well, you guys never played against three.
Huh?
You guys never played
against
three? Yeah. I don't want to play against three.
It was horrible. Yeah, because like for me, the era, I wasn't in that era, because that was Synchro, right? Because they had all their Synchros.
No, they didn't even have Synchros back then.
No?
No, they were just Samurai monsters.
Just Six of that?
Jesus.
So that was even before the Synchros came out?
Synchros exceeded the normal
shit.
Wow.
Okay, yeah. So like that deck, well, I guess it was just always deadly at one point.
It was.
Yeah. It's like, oh boy, I got a bajillion
points. Form field with a kind of Grandmaster.
Grandmaster.
No, that shit was hard.
But yeah.
Like, I don't want to live on this planet anymore.
Yeah.
It's slowly coming back.
Yeah.
But no, well, here's the thing that I see about it is that like right now in Japan, it's not doing a damn thing at three.
You know, at three right now in Japan?
It's
OCG?
At three.
Wow.
So that's why like it. I can somewhat understand why it came back, because also it's a profit hit, or it's a profit release, because now they have the Shadow of the Six Samurai coming out in the next few months.
Yeah. Well, no, I thought someone came out in Circuit Breaker.
No, I don't think so. I think it's coming out in the mid set. But anyways, like it's a pure profit banlist release. You know, so it's like. I don't know. I still don't see them doing too much, because now it's gonna be one of like that one sacky card. If they got it, they got it. If they don't,
In the OCG, they got rid of Trickstar Reincarnation.
Yeah.
Just because of how bad it was.
Yeah, just because of how often the OTKs came up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's freaking good. I'm like, why didn't we get that? I could have screwed that. Adam would have been happy.
Yeah,
to get
I
removed.
Really, really wish we didn't. They didn't have to deal with that bullcrap.
So we have Slumber next on our.
Yeah, we already spoke about that.
Okay, the True King's Return, that's another thing we talked about a little bit about, but it's another card that was an enabler for the True Dracos that we're glad is down to one. Well, it's at one now.
Yeah,
I mean,
still.
They still have to search it out. Interesting for you, Black Lesser Soldier on one of the beginnings at two.
I ran out of one, it's going to stay at one.
No, actually, I took him out of my BLS deck.
Yeah.
Now, the reason... For those of you watching it, maybe you didn't see my BLS Invoke deck, I actually decided to take BLS Envoy the Beginning out, because I find it always bricked, or I never had the light and the dark monsters in the graveyard in order to actually activate the effect. And so for me, I found I was using it more as a trade-in target than anything else. So now that it's at 2, and I'm like, God, come on, man. It's like,
hey, boy, you can replace it now. You got the slumber that's only not one. Put him in there.
I'd rather put in like an extra like trade-in or
draw
try the spellbook engine, because now that's still 100% viable.
Yeah.
Still.
I'm surprised they didn't take anything off the list for that.
No, in Japan they did, but not over here. So the spellbook engine is entirely...
Usable.
Yeah,
the dragon come back.
Actually, Luster Pendulum came on. Came is at 2 now.
Yeah, Luster Pendulum's at. Oh, that's the next card.
Yeah, that was Luster Pendulum.
Okay, now for the semi. Semi-limited.
Yeah.
Okay, that's obviously pendulums are severely nerfed once Link Summoning came into effect.
Mm-hmm.
So it's.
Did you see what else came off?
No.
Waver guys.
We'll get to it. No, we'll get to it.
Mathematician?
Mathematician?
He was limited, now he's semi.
He's like a pseudo foolish burial and you draw one. Mm-hmm. It's deck thinning.
Yeah,
but so it, depending on like the rank 3 variant deck that you're playing, it's actually not a bad card.
Okay. So Bryonic came back at 2.
It's not doing too much at the moment.
Yeah,
it hasn't been meta relevant for a while.
I'm surprised he didn't come back at 3 then.
It was wanted. When it came out, everyone wanted it, but you only ran it at one.
Librarian came back. TG Librarian. He's back at limited.
It's limited?
Yeah,
no,
it was limited. So now it's semi-limited. With that, I see it as...
The Rise of Stardust will return.
Stardust!
I don't see it being meta-relevant for the moment, mainly because obviously the Link... The Link mechanic itself is still young.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have a lot of the resources yet to enable TG Hyperlibrary to go off anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You know, not like before where it didn't matter, where you could just keep bringing back, you know, level leader and just keep synchro summoning up and up and up, and then you just keep getting a draw every damn time, you know? So it's not the same as it was before. So as of right now, I don't see it doing too much.
Mm-hmm.
But then give it some time, there will be a deck within the Link format that's gonna exploit the shit out of that,
mm-hmm.
and it's gonna get banned or limited again.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's only a matter of time for that.
Sure. Oh, Brain Control is back at 2.
Nobody ran it.
No. Because it's like you have to control. The normal monster you have to take control of, right? It's not a quick player match.
That's true. I don't know.
It's just a spell.
Yeah.
It's like garbage.
No one's really running it.
Burial from a Different Dimension.
I'm super
glad. It's at 2 now. Okay, next one is El Shaddoll Fusion.
No contracts, still garbage.
Don't worry, Edmund's contract could be coming back. It's like, why the hell else would they make it come back?
It's just cockies.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, you'll get it when it's not good anymore.
When nobody wants to play it.
Alright. Pre-preparation of rights.
No, preparation of rights.
Preparation of rights came back. Wasn't only at 1?
Yep.
Oh, well, now it's back at 2 now.
Yeah, well, because there's still like no real ritual deck that can utilize it as properly anyways.
Yeah.
So as of right now, like, I can understand why it's...
Cyber Angels can't use it?
They can use the shit out of that.
Oh.
But the thing is...
Ritual
decks haven't been like top tier in a very long time. You know, like for all we know, the Revengeance, when they get more support, they're gonna be, hopefully they're friggin' nuts, because then I got all the resources, you know, I got everything I need for that. But I mean, I would love for that deck to be like meta, because then I got everything for that, but, and then you have a ritual deck, one of the shittiest mechanics in the game, and it's a meta deck again, you know, it's...
Yeah. Yeah, it could be. Alright, now we're on to the off the list.
Oh man, this is the shit.
Yeah, this is the shit, man. Alright. The Breeze Dragon is off.
It's a fairly good card. Mm-hmm. I am not a huge fan of it, but I will hardly
Stardust Return.
The Rise of Stardust Lord.
Alright, Honest is back at 3 now.
And Honest?
That's a hand trap, man. It's a good hand trap.
It's essentially a hand battle trap.
Yeah.
Which isn't bad, it's just right now, like, I can understand why hand traps are such a big thing right now, but hand traps at the moment are made more for prevention and disruption, not a battle...
Oriented?
Yeah, a battle-oriented thing.
Well, I guess, that's what they would do, though, for the Lynx, because Lynx are all, they have to battle, like, they're all attack monsters, they don't really have defense shit going on for them.
So it all depends on what happens in the next few Link cards that come out, because if they don't come out with like a light oriented or a light attribute focused Link deck, then it's like gonna be for nothing.
The Rescue Crew.
Rescue
Cat and Rabbit are back at three.
Rescue Rabbit, I like. Yeah. As soon as I seen that, I was like pulling my hair out, and I was like, this is the Rabbit's best shit ever.
Do you ever read Rabbit's effect? You can't summon it from the deck, but you can normal summon it, and its effect is you can tribute it, banish it. While you tribute, banish it. And then you get to summon two monsters, the same...
Two normal monsters from the deck. Name. Now, the reason why I'm super hyped for this... Evil Swarms. I like lost my shit, and I'm like, oh my god, Evil Swarms next TCG meta,
Evil Swarms will rise again.
And the thing is, the way
they're a big heavy deck, extra deck monster. Like, if you get that, your Link guys are fucked.
Yeah, but that's the next problem, is if it's a Link heavy format, then Evil Swarms still ain't gonna do anything.
Well, Summoner Monk is back at 3 now.
That, I'm actually still saying thing. I'm actually really excited for that because of the same shit for Evil Swarms.
Okay, so next is Witch of the Black Forest is off.
It got the errata. It's not good anymore.
Yeah, I don't even know
what the errata is. It's like the exact same thing as like saying it. I don't know what the exact.
Oh, I think it only happened to like the end of the turn or something.
Yeah, it's something like that.
Okay. Charge Light Brigade.
Light Swarms are getting a major buff from this ban list because you got Honest at 3, you got Charge of Light Brigade back at 3, so it's a cert, middle.
Oh boy, I gotta deal with Light Swarms.
Twilight Swarms. You got Twilight Swarms, and so now, because you also have the Twilight Swarms in the deck, you also get Blackluster Soldier. Mm-hmm. So Blackluster Soldier at 2, you're more than likely to find it in your deck now. Yeah. That's number one. Number two, hopefully they don't mill it, but I mean, that's them, you know? They're playing the luck-based deck. It's up to them.
Oh, fuck. The luck-based deck.
Yeah, their mills could be complete shit, but you never know.
Dragon Ravine.
That was taken off the list?
Yeah, it's taken off the list. Oh, shit. That 3.
Gotta make my Dragoonies.
Yeah, Dragoonies.
Don't even make Dragoonies. They still suck.
Yeah. Those videos are uploaded. I haven't been able to work on them. It's been ridiculous. So it's like...
Yeah, especially with Destiny.
I was playing that today, actually. And Metroid came out too, so I'm like playing two games. But yeah, I wasn't around for Dragon Ravine, so that was during the Synchro Eras.
Yeah, that was
when it was running rampant.
Actually, I think
Rampant banned. Because it was semi-limited.
Yeah, it was semi-limited. It was limited. It was limited.
And once in a while, I kept coming back.
It's a once per turn Foolish Burial for dragons. And you know how dragon decks have to be in the graveyard.
Yeah, right? Red Eyes, Blue Eyes, okay. And then, Dragonuries, them two, they're that graveyard.
Yeah, you're free.
Well, I never played when Dragonuries came out. Yeah. And then the last one is Wavering Eyes is back at 3. Wavering Eyes? It was, you know what? It was the best card for Pendulums. If you were both playing Pendulum decks, whoever pulled Wavering Eyes first won.
Yeah.
It was like, whoever got Wavering Eyes won.
Okay, put it this way. You have your scales, right? Your opponent has scales. Your opponent activates Wavering Eyes. Fuck you. Wavering Eyes. You counter it. So basically what it does, it blows up all the scales. And the scales are gone. If you blow up two scales, you search for a Pendulum Monster. Mm-hmm. You blow up one, you burn your opponent for 500. You blow up three. What was the third effect?
I don't remember. It's been such a long time. It's been off the list.
And I think the third... Yeah, then the third one, you banish a monster on field, and the fourth one, you can search for another Wavering Eyes.
Yeah. So you just search for the. In fact, I said, if you both were playing it, whoever pulls it first usually won. It wasn't a quick play, that was a continuous.
It's a quick play.
Is it?
Oh my god.
I'm sorry, it was just deadly.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I'm surprised that card came back. We'll probably see Magician Pendulum playing that card. The shit out of it.
I'll have to get some.
Yeah, but...
Huh?
I said,
I'll have to get some.
Yeah. I took them all out because they became pointless.
Yeah.
Along with Chicken Game. I'm so sad that card.
I miss Chicken Game.
That's when the Ignites, they ruled.
Yeah. That's when you had your Exodia FTK variant.
That was my first tournament I came with that.
Then you actually got Exodia the one time.
Against a fucking... No, he tried to get Infinity out and he went to Nova. I was like, I ain't letting that happen. I think I saw him warning or striked him, and I was like, aha!
Yeah, I think it was warning because I think strike just came on in that set, and
yeah.
You didn't have
strike. Oh, yeah, because it was expensive. Yeah, so it was a warning. I was like, I ain't letting that happen. He's like, oh, so I just kept holding him off until I'm like, Exodia! And everybody in
They lost their shit.
Yeah, everybody lost their shit in that tournament. I was like, oh, Exodia! Yeah, it was cool because they're like, oh, we fucking did it with an Ignite deck. I was like, yeah! Oh, yeah, it was good times. But that's the end of our list. That was the last one. Yeah.
So, all right, so final thoughts. Quinn, you start.
Yeah.
I don't know what to say.
Well, you see some cards come back that haven't really been.
The only one I would be excited about, Dragon Ravine.
Dragon Ravine? he got his titties hard. I'll go next.
Go ahead.
I'm happy that True Draco shit finally got hit, and Zeus too. Because fuck, we've had like a toxic
6 months
format. Like, it's been garbage. Like, I hate going to a locals and then someone whips that out. I'm like, come on, man. Like, you're going to a locals. Like, play a fun deck. Like, yeah, you could be there to win, but play a deck that's fun. Like, when people see that, they're upset. It's like,
I'm going to enjoy shitting on you.
Yeah, that's what it is. It's like that or Zodiacs. Like, I made a variant, but I don't even play it. Like, it was like just fun to mess around with, but then we lost Terratop, so that was something. But I haven't touched it since. But as I said, I didn't abuse it. I just liked it just to see what it was like, and I'm like, okay, I can see the abuse in this deck. One card equals five.
Yeah, one card plus five instant flip.
So like that, I'm happy Zoos are finally gone. Dracos are hopefully on their way out, and maybe we'll get an emergency balance because they're like, okay, we didn't hit the right card. We gotta get rid of Masterpiece, like, or Diagram, something. Get rid of something. Yeah, I guess some cards that I'm sad about that are missing, that are all gone now, Dagusto, because I like using that card, not even just for whatever. And Dark Hole, getting set back to one kind of sucks ass. So it's like, now we got less field life. We only got one Dark Hole and one Raigeki. It kind of sucks. Sucks donkey dick. So I guess that's my thoughts. Like, wow, some other card that came off, like Rescue Rab. But Rescue Rab's cool that came back. I'll also hand it off to Captain Oji.
All right. So for me, I'm super glad Zeus dead. True Dragos, I really, really wish they had done a little bit better job on hitting the more problem cards, which are Masterpiece and Diagram. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, they did hit the enablers of the deck, the single tribute monsters, so that they don't start building the resources as fast as they did before.
Yeah.
So I understand why they didn't hit the whole deck as it was, but at the same time, I kind of wish they did.
They probably should have, because they probably already know that deck is
it's not good.
Especially for their format with the links now, it's not good.
Anyway, so there was that. But then I'm super glad stuff like, Rescue Rabbit came off the list, you know? I'm super glad that's at three. It says that Evil Swarms are going to be able to, my Evil Swarm deck's going to be half decent again, you know? But the only thing is, True Jakers are still going to be around. True Jakers are still going to be a pain in the butt to deal with. But in the upcoming format, because now we're looking into the short distance future, and we're getting stuff like the Spiral Link Monster. And Spiral Link's supposed to be friggin' nuts after that.
Yeah. But, that's all we're missing, right? Yeah. The Link Monster?
No, it's only time will tell, really. Oh, and a handful of extra, Link Monsters.
For
Spiral? Yeah, random Link Monsters. Other than that, everything else is I'm pretty much okay with. You know, I kind of wish that Dinosaurs were going to be around a bit longer, because even Dinosaurs, I had a legitimately fun time playing against that deck. So I'm a little sad that it's going to be gone now.
Yeah. Well, I mean, who knows? Maybe somebody will find a way to keep it alive.
Yeah, we'll see what happens.
There's always something. Mm-hmm. Our discussion, our likes, dislikes of the ban list. Did you have any hopes, like, future-wise?
Future-wise? Emergency ban list, Mr. Masterpiece. That's it.
Masterpiece. Anything from your past to come back?
No.
I don't want to deal with that shit anymore.
No Dragnudies, none? No. Well, none of this is bad with Dragnudies, huh?
No.
Oh.
Just whatever they use.
And I still hope for Stratos.
Nobody wants Stratos.
Stratos might come back one day.
No.
Well, that's the end of our video. This is Team KOP. Like, share, subscribe, and thanks for watching. This is
Captain OJ,
Ninja Boy,
and GuardedKam, and peace out.